As we have already described that this word gravitation is name given to force between any two bodies in this universe. So the first thing which we deduce from this chapter is Newton's law of gravitation. Okay. What does this law state? Newton's law of gravitation or Newton's gravitational law. So according to this law, force, suppose these are two bodies M1 and M2, let it be present anywhere in the universe. Let us say one body is moon, another body is something in this room. One body could be a rock, second body could be sun, any two bodies in this entire universe. So Newton's law is gravitation. According to this law, force of attraction, because gravitational force suggests that every two bodies in this universe attract each other with a force. So according to this law, any two bodies in this universe attract each other with a force which is directly proportional to product of their masses and inversely proportional to, suppose the distance between them from center to center is r, and this force is inversely proportional to square of distance between them. So if you combine these two facts, you will get this force is proportional to m1 m2 over r square, right? So there will be a constant of proportionality involved in this case, that is universal gravitational contest, which is universal gravitational constant, which is represented by capital G. So the equation becomes F is equal to G m1 m2 over r square. This is the mathematical form of Newton's gravitational law or Newton's law of gravitation. So I would repeat, according to the law, any two bodies in this universe attract each other with a force which is directly proportional to product of their mass and inversely proportional to square of distance between them. So now we have an equation. What else can we say about G? First of all, there must be some numerical value associated with G. G is 6.67 raised to 10 raised to the power minus 11. This is the numerical value, and the SI unit would be, leave G here and take all the terms on that side. You already have force, that is Newton. Then this r square, that is the SI unit is meter square. Meter square is getting multiplied with force. So Newton meter square over this mass into mass is what? Kg into kg. So kg square. So this is the whole square unit of G. Can we also find the dimensional formula for G? Let's try. We have F is equal to G m1 m2 over r square. That gives me G is equal to F r square upon m1 m2. So if I have to find the dimension formula, I'll do this. Or so I'm right now, I have to put the dimension formula of every single term. Here force is what? MLT minus 2. Then r square. R square is distance square. Distance is what? Meter. That is length square upon what is mass into mass? M square, right? So this will give me m1 and m minus 2. So this is giving me m minus 1, then l 2 plus 1 3, and lastly t minus 2. So this is the dimensional formula of G.